We're on the roof, we're with our checklist now, and we're looking at the array portion of the checklist. As a part of that, we need to inspect the wiring methods that they used on this project. Now, here we got some cable tray, and we've got a couple good examples of the do's and don'ts as it relates to installing cables on the cable tray. Here we can see we've got good spacing. We want one conductor width, so it's about as wide as my index finger. We got a little more, that's good. We've got plenty here. This is a really good spacing. Code instructs us the width of one conductor. Here we've got four conductors that are all tight together. These conductors would need to be spread out. There would be derating that would have to be applied to those conductors. So what I'm gonna recommend to the contractor, he's got plenty of room on the rack. I'm sure this was probably a simple oversight, but I'm gonna instruct him to just spread those out and give me one conductor width of space between each one. Additionally, what we care about is that these conductors are strapped down, that they're not smaller than 1/0, unless we're talking about the equipment grounding conductor, in which case it could be as small as a number 4. We're good to go there. Over here, we want to look at this expansion fitting. So here we've got a joint between two trays, and we see a bonding jumper. That bonding jumper, we can see, already has some rust on it. The problem with rust is it's not conductive. What the code tells us is that the equipment we're installing needs to be suitable for the environment. Obviously, if we've got rust, it's not suitable for this environment. We've lost our continuity, and that's gonna have to be repaired. So as a part of the final process at the end, we'll review all those things with the client. Okay, another part of our inspection here today is gonna be the raceways. Now here we can see they've primarily used PVC on the roof. And what we care about is a few things. We care about the support, and we're gonna follow that support here. We've gotta have support within 3 feet of the terminal adapter here. We've got that, and we've gotta have support going up. The requirements for the support are gonna be right out of chapter 3. It's 352 is for PVC. And as we look further up, we can see there's some expansion fittings. There's a table in the section 352. It's table 352.44. And that's gonna give us a chart and some guidance on how to determine when and where we need to use those expansion fittings. In the case of this project, those expansion fittings were pre-identified as a part of the plan review, which makes it a lot easier for this part of the inspection. So really all we're doing is matching up what's on the plans with what's here on the site. This pipe, this is a short pipe stub that exits the combiner box. What we really care about here is that one is that that pipe stub is less than 2 feet and that the fill of that pipe is less than 43%. Now, as long as we can achieve those two things, we don't have to worry about any conductor derating. And that's gonna be real important when we further explore this cable tray system. But for right now, what we need to look at is we've got something that's less than 2 feet. The fill is definitely less than 43%, although we could calculate it. But here we want to make sure that the end of this raceway is sealed. Now that's really important on PV systems. Obviously you don't want any moisture or water getting into the enclosure if you can help it. But the other big problem is insects. Bees, bugs, all kinds of critters will crawl in there and make a nice house out of this box. So we can see that on this project, this pipe is sealed properly.